zero for 10 years. I chose you.
I'm a good R-Truth.
I'm not dead till you tune me.
No more.
I'm officially giving every last one of y'all the boot. See you later, bye. I'm not waiting in line no more like I did. When I see an opportunity, I'm going to take it.
R-Truth has become
completely unhinged.
This guy's sick.
That made me a believer that.
Somebody call the cops! Police!
Action,
I'm sorry.
Dude, speak louder than words. This whole conspiracy thing is about John Cena. These people here
make sure
that it's all about
you. It's a conspiracy.
I gotta go get the new John Cena t-shirt.
Everywhere John.
Propaganda tool designed to make all these people feel good.
Big Jimmy got on a John Cena t-shirt too.
I don't care about these people. I don't care about how they feel.
10 years
of frustration and disappointment.
No more.
It's all about me. And I ain't gonna feel right until I get my WWE championship.
That's the truth, the whole truth, and what then?
There's millions of people all over the world in the WWE universe would love to be John Cena. You look in the eyes of R-Truth and that goes away. Nobody would want to be John Cena this Sunday. He's a complete nutcase and he scares me. I wouldn't want to be in the ring with R-Truth.
Well, it will be R-Truth battling John Cena for the WWE title this Sunday live on pay-per-view.
I know that we talked about this already, but I just feel so bad about what happened last week. I was so mad. I'm not like that usually. Mm. Just that little one made me so angry. And I was a beautiful person. I just love that purse.
I understand. You love that purse. And that little troll is going to suffer. I'm going to make sure of it.
Good. Mm-hmm. You should. Mm-hmm. But good news.
Oh, yeah?
So, I brought my purse to my guy, and he can fix it. Thank God, right?
Baby, you didn't have to do that. You know I would have taken care of that for you.
It's no big deal. I give them your credit card.
Oh. Great.
They are the most defiant and controversial force in WWE history.
You make your rules, and we will break them!
Break them down!
Now, their final moments of mayhem are yours in DX One Last Stand.
That's the beautiful thing about these DX videos, even the stuff you don't remember, which for us is most everything. You just pop this in the DVD player and see it all.
Break it down! Ooh,
with exclusive behind-the-scenes access of the most entertaining duo ever. Here's your chance to own the finale of the D-Generation X era.
If you're not down with that, we only got two words for ya.
Own it. DX One Last Stand, available on Blu-ray and DVD now.
Let's just stop talking so we can go.
Oh, jeez, I'm glad this is over. I'm so sick of you anyway.
10 years of the deal with you like an idiot.
Welcome back to NXT Redemption, and here comes Delish, a.k.a. William Regal, Steal Your Girl.
A.k.a. Officer Dibble.
But Tyson Kidd, his pro, who's done a really good job molding Lucky this season.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, weighing in at 256 pounds, Lucky Kidd.
It will be very hard for any rookie to fail with the excellent Tyson Kidd in that corner. If you can't learn from this man, then you're not capable of learning anything. You don't belong here. That man, it's just a matter of time before Tyson Kidd is a huge superstar in the WWE. Lucky Cannon is lucky enough to be a part of that.
Do you envision Lucky Cannon one day being a huge superstar in the WWE?
He's got everything in the
You know, I saw what R-Truth did to Hornswoggle on Raw. And it was great. And after the way that little troll tried to embarrass me in front of Maurice, I thought to myself there was nothing that could make me luckier than doing the same exact thing when he gets back. As a matter of fact, that's exactly what I'm gonna do. The second Hornswoggle gets back, I am going to boot him in his face.
That was pretty blunt.
Certainly was.
Well, I know the WWE Universe is really excited now to see Hornswoggle.
And here's one from Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 273 pounds, Titus O'Neil.
But as we showed you earlier, unfortunately, Hornswoggle will not be here after the brutal beatdown that R-Truth handed Hornswoggle last night on Monday Night Raw.
R-Truth's completely lost the plot. I mean, he's gone completely Rajput. It's a shame that Hornswoggle's not here, because this is a night when Titus needs his pro with him. He needs that support system. And he doesn't have it. It's crucial this week, crucial.
As you may recall earlier tonight, these two basically had a war of words on the microphone. Lucky Cannon said basically Titus O'Neil had zero talent, zero personality, and would make $0 for this company. Ooh.
Lucky Cannon's a smart man. He knows that that's not true, but it's just to get into the, under the skin of Titus O'Neil. Because tonight's the night that you've got to try and throw everybody off their game if you want to stay a part of NXT.
Well, the WWE Universe is looking for the best pure athlete on NXT while they vote. It's really hands down Titus O'Neil's match to win, isn't it?
Without a doubt. Titus O'Neil, as you said, he's a Hall of Famer in Florida. Where is it?
The University of Florida, that's in Gainesville.
Yes. But I mean, the man's he's an incredible athlete, incredible power. You know, all the athletes here in NXT are in all incredible condition, but he just has that something extra.
Cover here.
But you can see just the look in his eyes, just the look you can see in his face. Something missing, that something is Hornswoggle.
Titus O'Neil, the former member of the Jacksonville Jaguars, but ever since, as you may recall, Hornswoggle was kidnapped by Chavo Guerrero and his rookie, Darren Young, Titus O'Neil has not been the same. He was undefeated at that point. Since then, he's been, let's call it like it is, he's been very average.
You have to wonder whether Titus O'Neil got a little too attached to Hornswoggle. That's probably been very detrimental to his career here in NXT. He's let it get to him. Hornswoggle's easy prey, let's be honest. He's easy prey for somebody to see that and to take advantage of it. And it's obviously affecting Titus in a big way.
Well, Titus O'Neil may be attached to Hornswoggle, but Lucky Cannon, no doubt, is very attached to Maurice. Spent $3,500 on a purse last week. You heard Maurice say, as a cover here by Cannon, say she took Lucky's credit card to get the purse fixed. I'm sure that won't be a cheap job.
I'm sure it won't. It probably cost just as much to fix it as it was to buy it in the first place. I wouldn't know. I've never spent that much on any woman, really.
What about that purse that you carry around?
What?
The fanny pack?
My pressure.
How much did you pay for that?
Don't let this shock.
I was in the center pages of Italian Vogue. Did you know that?
I did not.
No, there's not many people can say that.
Meanwhile, Lucky Cannon beating down the bigger, stronger Titus O'Neil. Lucky Cannon from Newport Richey, Florida, looking for redemption this season after he was eliminated.
Does that look on Titus's face? It's just... It's like he's lost the world.
Well, it's all about overcoming adversity, isn't it? I mean, if Titus O'Neil can't get Hornswoggle out of his head and beat Lucky Cannon, he's going to have real issues when he goes up against somebody like the Big Show.
You have to put any problems that you have, you have to be a professional. You have to leave those behind. You can't worry if you're having a bad day, if you've had the worst family crisis. You have to leave that alone. Now's the time to perform. And Lucky Cannon's just not bringing it.
Another near fall there for Lucky Cannon. He wanted me to mention that in high school he was voted most likely to steal your girl, which is where his nickname came from. Again, the cover.
But he wouldn't want to steal any of my girls.
It wouldn't be stealing, you just let him have them.
Right, yes.
give up, Titus.
Titus O'Neil, it's just not that fire in his. You see that, Todd? There's just not the fire in his eyes that he normally has, and it hasn't been.